indigent man o hindi, may existing pension o wala, lahat ng senior citizens meron ng pension.
Congratulations! House Bill 10423 is hereby approved in second reading.
Speaker, I move that we recognize the Honorable Representative Stella Kimbo of the 2nd District of Marikina City to sponsor the measure.
The amiable Congresswoman is once again recognized representing the City of Marikina. You may proceed.
Salamat, Mr. Speaker. As reported by the Philippine Statistics Authority, the number of Filipino senior citizens was approximately 9.2 million in 2020, and this demographic is expected to rise significantly in the coming decades. Currently, our elderly population bears a disproportionate burden of health expenses, with a staggering 59% of these costs being out of pocket. These financial strains are compounded by the limited coverage of pension schemes, with only about 30% of seniors receiving benefits based on their work history. Yet, many of our seniors perform an important economic activity, and they are unpaid for this. And this is child care. Ika nga, apostolic ministry. Kung wala sila na tagapag-alaga ng mga apo, walang tagahatid sa school ng mga apo, hindi makakatrabaho ang maraming magulang. Many women will remain outside the labor force. Mr. Speaker, sa palagay ko, ay oras na na magbigay halaga sa economic contribution ng ating mga seniors. So today, I stand before you to sponsor a bill of utmost importance, an essential piece of legislation aimed at securing the well-being and dignity of our senior citizens. This bill seeks to render eligibility for a social pension as mandatory for all Filipino senior citizens, expanding the provisions of the existing RA number 9994, also known as the Expanded Senior Citizens Act. Our seniors have been very grateful of the social pension for the indigent. Pero nagkakaroon po tayo ng malaking problema sa pagtutukoy o pag-identify kung sino ba ang indigent senior. Marami po, Mr. Speaker, ang nagsasabi, bakit ang kapitbahay ko kasama sa social pension pero siya po ay mas mayaman sa akin? Hanggang ngayon, hindi pa lahat nabibigyan ng karampatang pension. Less than half are currently covered by the program. So this proposal before us addresses these challenges head on. Through this measure, indigent seniors will continue to receive their 1,000 pesos monthly pension, and the rest of the senior citizen population who are not currently covered will receive at least 500 pesos per month. By mandating a social pension for all seniors, we ensure that every elderly citizen in our country has a basic level of income security. Indigent man o hindi, may existing pension o wala, lahat ng senior citizens meron ng pension. Uulitin ko po, ibig sabihin, matik na ang pagiging kasapi sa social pension. Basta edad 60. May SSS pension man o wala, may GSIS pension man o wala, kasama na po. Therefore, I urge all my distinguished colleagues to support this bill, ensuring a safer, more secure future for our senior citizens, a future where their needs are not just met, but safeguarded with the full backing of our government. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and esteemed colleagues, for considering this vital piece of legislation. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much, sponsor, majority leader.
Mr. Speaker, there being no member who wishes to interpolate, I move that we terminate the period of sponsorship and debate.
There being no members wishing to interpolate, There's a motion to terminate the period of sponsorship in debate. Any objection? There being none, motion is approved. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we open the period of amendments.
Is there any objection? The period of amendments is now open. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, there being no committee nor individual amendments, I move that we terminate the period of amendments. Mr. Speaker, I withdraw my previous motion. I move that we recognize the Honorable Dagaok, Sergio Dagaok, to introduce the individual amendments.
Okay. Congressman Dagaok, you may proceed for your proposed amendments.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, distinguished sponsor. Would the distinguished sponsor amenable to some amendments?
Yes, Mr. Speaker.
The first individual amendment that this representation would like to introduce is on page 3, under section 2, delete lines 10 to 20.
I accept, Mr. Speaker.
Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we adopt the amendment.
Is there any objection? The hereby amendments therefore accepted. You may proceed.
The final proposed amendment is on page 4 under section 4. Delete the phrase, the representatives of senior citizens organization in the House of Representatives and the Senate, the SWD, Department of Finance, Department of Tourism, Housing and Urban Development Coordinating Council, Department of Labor and Employment, Department of Justice, Department of the Interior and Local Government, Department of Trade and Industry, Department of Health, Department of Transportation and Communications, National Economic and Development Authority, Department of Education, Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, Commission on Higher Education, and 5 non-government organizations or people's organizations for the senior citizens duly accredited by DSWD, after the word with and replaced with other relevant agencies and stakeholders.
I accept, Mr. Speaker.
What is the position of the majority?
Mr. Speaker, I move that we adopt the amendment.
Is there any objection? The chair hears none. The hereby amendments are therefore approved.
That's all, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, distinguished sponsor.
Mr. Speaker, there being no member who wishes to propose individual amendments, I move that we terminate the period of amendments.
There is a motion to terminate the period of amendments. Any objection? Chair hears none. Motion is approved. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we now vote on second reading House Bill number 10423 as amended.
There's a motion to approve House Bill 10423 as amended. All those who are in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those who are not in favor, please say nay. The ayes have it. Congratulations. House Bill 10423 is hereby approved in second reading.